मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, दिस इज प्रकाश कुमार गुप्ता फ्रॉम ब्रिलियंट पब्लिक स्कूल बेहतराई। टुडे द न्यू टॉपिक इज चैप्टर नंबर 6, दैट इज क्वांटिफिकेशन एंड न्यूमेरिकल एप्लीकेशंस। व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ क्वांटिफिकेशन ऑफ नंबर्स? इट इज द एक्ट ऑफ काउंटिंग एंड मेजरिंग। सो फर्स्ट टॉपिक इज कमिंग अंडर द क्वांटिफिकेशन ऑफ नंबर्स, दैट इज average. So to find the average or the mean of a group of numbers, we divide the sum of all the numbers by the number of numbers in the group, or we can say sum of all the observations divided by number of observations. To find the average of the quiz scores included in example, suppose some example is there, so how we will find the average? We will add all the scores, that is 30, and then divide by the number of scores. How many numbers of scores are there? Total 5. So divided by 5. So we are getting 30 divided by 5, that is 6 points. So average score is 6 points. That only is average. The next topic is clock. What are the things we have to keep in our mind when we are studying about the clock? Clock is a circle whose circumference is divided into 60 equal parts, and all are known as minute spaces. So 1 minute space is equal to 60 degree, like 360 degree divided by 60. So if we cancel, we are getting 6. So 6 degree only 1 minute is equal to. Next is, if two hands, that is minute hand and hour hand only we are considering, so if they both are coinciding, so they are having 0 minute space apart. If two hands are in opposite direction, that means one is opposite to another one, then 30 minute space apart we will have. If relative gain is 60 minute space apart, then actual gain is 60 minute, because if minute hand is moving along with that, our hand is also moving but very slow. Okay, so if in a clock, suppose minute hand is completing one circle, that time our hand is completing 5 minutes space apart. So that is why relative gain is 60 minutes space apart, then actually it is 55 minutes space apart. If relative gain is 55 minute space apart, then actual gain is 60 minute. The next topic is about calendar. Here the important things: each non-century year divisible by 4 and century year divisible by 400 are coming under leap year, and rest all are ordinary years we are considering. Days more than complete week, like if you are starting from Sunday, so after completing the Sunday, some more days are there, those are known as odd days. One ordinary year has only one odd day. How? 365 days total in a year for ordinary. So if we are dividing it by 7, so we are getting 52 weeks plus 1 day. That means 1 day is odd year for 1 year. So similarly, for a leap year, how many odd days will be there? 1 day plus 1 day extra for leap year, because February is having 29 days, so one more day. That means, so odd days will be 2 odd days in leap year. If 100 years are there, then how many odd days will have? 5 odd days. For 400 years, it will be 0 odd days. Now, odd days are 0 for Sunday, 1 for Monday, 2 for Tuesday, 3 for Wednesday. Likewise, for Saturday, we have 6 odd days. Next is time and work. The basic assumption we have while solving the problems on time and work are: the total work is always taken as 1 unit. Next, the work done by a person is uniform throughout the working time. For example, if a person a work in T days, then the person T day work is equal to 1. That work is completed. Then the work done in one day will be how much? Just 1 by T. If two persons can alone finish a work in X days and Y days separately, then together they can finish a work in this many days. Now, if two persons together can do a work in X days and one of them alone can do it in Y days, then the other person can alone do it in X into Y by Y minus X days. If three persons are working similarly in place of two persons, and three persons are finishing a work separately, T1, T2 and T3 days, then in one day they will work 1 by T1 plus 1 by T2 plus 1 by T3, one person. So D1 by T1 plus D2 by T2 plus D3 by T3 is equal to 1. That complete work will be done. Next is time and distance. Here speed is equal to, since childhood we are knowing, distance upon time. Time is equal to distance upon speed, and distance is equal to speed into time. These three formula. Now, kilometer per hour to meter per second, if we are converting, so for x kilometer per hour we will multiply 5 by 18 meter, then it will be converted into meter per second. If meter per second is converted into kilometer per hour, then x meter per second we have to multiply by just opposite or reciprocal of the previous one, 18 by 5. If the ratio of the speeds of A and B is A is to B, then ratio of time taken will be reciprocal, 1 upon A is to 1 upon B, or we can say B is to A. Suppose a man covers a certain distance in x kilometer and an equal distance at y kilometer, then the average speed during the whole journey will become 2 into xy upon x plus y kilometer per hour. The next topic in quantification is mensuration. Mensuration, so many things we have already studied in previous classes. So just quick review it is. All the formula is given for triangle, how to find area of the triangle, how to find perimeter of the triangle. Similarly for parallelogram, rhombus, rectangle, square, trapezoid or trapezium, then circle. So all areas as well as perimeter or circumference. Now this all was for 2D. These diagrams are for 2D diagrams. Now these diagrams are 3D diagrams. So here we have to see volume. These are coming under volume. So volume, area, which type of area? Curved surface area. This is CSA. And the next one is TSA. Okay. So all these formula are given to you. Using these formula, so many questions we have to solve. Next is seating arrangement. Total four types of seating arrangements are there. First one is coming linear seating arrangement. Suppose in the seating arrangement, someone is sitting facing south and some are sitting facing north. So you can see how which side right will be there and which side left will be there. Then the second type of seating arrangement is circular seating arrangement. In this, if they are facing inside, then how left and how right will be there, you can observe here. The next is coming rectangular seating arrangement. So in rectangular seating arrangement, how left and how right will be taken, you can see here, and they all are facing the center. Then it is. Thank you very much.